Howard Cosell, live at ringside, Los Angeles Memorial Sports Arena. We have just completed round one of a middleweight contest between Muhammad Zahoui and Virgil Hill. Hill of the United States, Zahoui of Algeria, and Hill a clear winner of the first round. The events here in the sports arena, and I am not overstating, have been simply amazing. Three Americans went into the ring this morning. Steve McCrory won, Jerry Page won, Frank Tate won on a walkover against a scheduled West German opponent who had fractured his right wrist in his prior fight. We pick up with round two. Hill outboxing the Algerian in round one, but the Algerian's mere presence betokens the fact that I have been making throughout the competition the progress of boxing in other countries. For the first time in this competition, there are certain medalists from Algeria, the Dominican Republic, Zambia, never from those countries before. And they are improving and improving. Muhammad Zahoui has been very impressive in his prior bouts. The referee is Roman Rangowski of Poland, the judges, and they are so important, the judges and the jurors too, are from Italy, Ecuador, Colombia, Korea, and Pakistan. This is second round action. The first round was not an action fight. We come off one of the greatest action fights I have ever seen in amateur boxing, literally. Good score there by Hill. He is boxing very intelligently. Jerry Page, by the way, was in a terrific fight earlier, but won. I don't know where these fighters are getting their energy from. This is the time when stamina and durability is the ultimate yardstick. So many fights so quickly. Hill scoring well there, the second round more than half over. The fight to which I alluded seconds ago was between Christopher Chiosso of France and Sean O'Sullivan of Canada. A brilliant fight by the French fighter. I thought he won cleanly, convincingly. The judges voted for him. The fight had to be reviewed by the jurors. They voted for O'Sullivan, overturning the decision, and I thought it was terribly unjust. Now, Muhammad Zahoui of Algeria trying to come after Hill. But Hill fighting his fight very carefully and very controllingly. There's a good combination to the belly and a good left to the belly. And we're within the final minute of the second round. And Virgil Hill is in control. This was the man going into the competition. Nobody figured would even have a chance for a gold medal. But if he wins this, he's got a big chance. He's in the finals. And he switched a few seconds ago to a left-handed stance. He's rather adept at that. It confused the Algerians. And now, back in his normal stance, the quick combinations, the quick hands, and then the left to the belly. And we are closing down at the end of round two with Virgil Hill very much in command.
Star Wars, Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid, The Sound of Music. In the tradition of these great films about fighting back against the odds, 20th Century Fox presents another milestone in motion picture history. Revenge of the Nerds.
Nerds!
Nerds.
Nerds.
Nerds! They've been laughed at. Picked on. And put down.
I'm not kissing a nerd.
But now it's time for the odd to get even.
Their action tonight demands an immediate retaliation.
How many cameras do we have left?
They should do it.
Oh, here she comes. Go left, go left.
Oh, no. Oh,
the nerd saw me naked.
Revenge of the Nerds.
Are all the nerds as good as you?
Rated R.
Check newspaper for theater.
Memorial Sports Arena, third and final round action, middleweight, semifinal action. And it is Virgil Hill of the United States quickly scoring points with the left, as he's been doing, but he's been very effective with the right. The Algerian gives you the belly. He's been taking advantage of it, and that is the way to score points. The Algerian opponent is Mohamed Zaoui. He is 21, Virgil Hill is 20. And this is one of the most controlled fights you could want to see. Look at Hill with the left. The Algerian now desperate. The mouthpiece knocked out by Hill. So some quick repair. Oh, it wasn't the mouthpiece. Thought it was. Oh, must have been a piece of tape. And still, Hill with the left again. Algerian, sparse now with the blows. Trying to work to the inside. Hill covering. Algerian did get a left up against Hill's righting. There's the right leg, then down to the stomach. Remember I said the Algerian gives you the belly. Good combination by Hill, even though Muhammad's back locked out. Hill flows from your view. There was a good shot by the Algerian, and another good left. Hill going back to being cautious. The number of blows thrown and scored by Hill so far outnumber those by Mohamed Zaoui, and it isn't even funny. Crowd is booing for whatever reason. They've got bloodthirsty. Not every fight can be a Tioso O'Sullivan bout. And I tell you, when O'Sullivan meets Tate in the final tomorrow, I've said it before, it would fill any arena in the country. Probably create more interest than any professional fight around. Saturday they'll fight. I think I inadvertently said tomorrow. Look at Hill giving it to him. Just teeing off on him. Swangowski breaks them up. No standing. And Mohamed Zaoui is now bleeding from the nose. Final minute, Virgil Hill in complete command. And he will move in to the finals. And America already assured of, at the worst, 4 silver medals. Look at that. Just teeing off. And we're down to, as you see, 22, 21, 20, 19, 18, and counting down. And with almost every second ticked off, Hill scores another left. A very easy, deliberate, purposeful victory for the American middleweight. Mohamed Zaoui of Algeria, the opponent, he will get a bronze medal. And so, Hill goes to his corner. No, he'll go over now. Congratulate the opponent's corner.
Finally got it.
I got a surprise for you. Come on, you earned it. Take it for a spin.
You need it?
Come on, get in there.
You thought it was over. But they're back for the summer of 84. Crab Legs 2 at Red Lobster. Order any entree, and for only $3, you get Crab Legs 2. It's a blockbuster. 1/2 pound of irresistible snow crab legs. It's the big deal of the summer. It's Crab Legs 2. Premiering now at a Red Lobster near you. You can't afford to miss it.
We're back live in the Los Angeles Memorial Sports Arena, awaiting what should be an unanimous decision for Virgil Hill over Mohamed Zaoui of Algeria, Virgil Hill of the United States. This was action from the third round, and it was this way throughout the fight. Virgil Hill scoring repeatedly. It became the most redundant pattern you could want to see. only sparse punches thrown by the Algerian, and it was no contest at all. The two shake hands, Gramkowski of Poland between them, and here it is. 5-0
in the blue corner, Virgil Hill.
5-0. There's no way the judges and the jurors could foul that one out. No way. Then I didn't think there was any way they could in the up. So that's the story here at the moment in the Los Angeles Memorial Sports Arena. Let's quickly return to Kathleen Sullivan.